2013 Grand Final. It has been an incredible journey. We've all seen athleticism, mental agility, and chess grandmaster tactics, just not on this programme. But we have seen five fine comedians trying their very best. Who will rise to the top? Who will become the Emperor of Nonsense? The Crown Prince of the Pointless? The Monarch of being a right silly billy? Only time will tell. Let us greet them for the last time. Ardal Handler! Bridget Christie! Chris Ramsey! Judi and Sophie Juca! And next to me, my faithful servant, a man who once told me after a few drinks that he has a separate bank account that his wife doesn't know about.
Let's
So up for this.
Oh, man, you seem really pumped. You love a final, don't you?
Love a final.
Oh.
Wearing my combat pre-ripped suit. And I'm ready. So let's just do it, Greg.
You look really cool. Ah! Let's just do it.
I had a Lucozade. Shall we start?
What is the final prize task category of the series, please?
They've been asked to bring in the finest family heirloom. Ooh. Exactly. The finest family heirloom, in your opinion, will gain 5 fine points for its owner. And at the end of this episode, the person with the most points will take home their family heirloom and 4 other people's family heirlooms, which feels so wrong, it must be right.
So sell me your family heirlooms. Christopher.
My finest family heirloom is an antique Italian coffee table.
It sounds very stylish.
It is.
Here it is.
It was purchased by my mum's mum and dad. In the 70s, I believe.
Surprisingly tasteful for a 70s item.
Yeah. You open the top of that bad boy and it plays the theme from The Godfather.
Ooh. That is a strong note. Sophie, can you beat a coffee table that plays The Godfather theme?
I think I can. It's not Italian, but it is a rice cooker.
Well, I hope it plays music when you open it.
There's an ancient African proverb. It goes, there is rice at home. When you're a little kid and you go out to the shops and you see a chocolate bar, your mum's like, there's rice at home. You see a margarita pizza, your mum's like, there's rice at home. You see a PlayStation, rice.
Rice. Is this the actual rice cooker from when you were a child?
This is the actual rice cooker from when I was a child.
That's quite cute.
It's never made imperfect rice, and it fills up not just my belly, but my soul.
Wow. Wow.
Don't try and emotionally manipulate.
I've got to be honest, Ardal, she's done a pretty good job of emotionally manipulating me. Your turn, though. Can you do the same?
I brought a biscuit tin.
Whoa.
I inherited that from my mother, who got it from her mother, and her mother, as a baby, arrived in Ireland with very few possessions in 1917, when Europe was in turmoil.
That's good.
And it's what's in the biscuit tin, I suppose, is what's really relevant and what's really poignant. What we were told it was my granny's papers, her birth cert.
You shorten that, do you? It's interesting that you shortened birth certificate.
Oh, yeah, birth certificate. I mean, we've got lots of time. I can use the full word.
So the trouble with you is there's part of me that thinks you've just made all of that up.
So I mock your ancestry, do I? Do I go on about the Welsh giants you were descended from?
I'll take some time to decide whether I believe any of that. Bridget.
The most precious thing that has been handed down is DNA. My proudest achievement, the thing that is
Excuse
most
me, can
precious...
I just... And I hate to interrupt
Oh,
so
no,
early.
That is very rude. Well,
he made me say the whole word for cert, so I think the least you could do is...
DNA. What, deoxynucleic acid? My proudest achievement is my children. I have brought a box with my children's teeth and hair and umbilical cord stops and pregnancy kits in it.
Yes, she has. And there it is.
And when they've gone, I will have that. And
unless you lose tonight.
Then it is going to be given away to one of four virtual strangers.
Well, I don't think they'll want it.
It is very touching. Judy.
My family heirloom is my blood.
We're really pushing what kids want to inherit.
Well, the reality is my blood's been passed down from generation to generation to generation. And it will continue to pass down. And if they need more, I can give them more.
Under what circumstances would your children need a vial of your blood?
A medical thing, a ritual thing. And that blood is going to carry on a legacy, because it'll be in my kids' body, their kids' body.
Yeah, but it's already in them. What's this necklace?
This necklace is if my blood starts to disappear. They can still have my blood.
Just so you know, you can store blood for 42 days. Do you want to... Do you want to judge?
The least obvious heirloom is probably a small bottle of blood. But I've got to recognise what an amazing bullshitter Judy Love is. I'm going to give her 2 points.
OK.
I really want a coffee table that plays The Godfather. I was touched by the rice maker. I've chosen to believe Ardal's biscuit tin story, so I'm going to give them all 4 points.
OK.
But Bridget's, when I saw that little box, I thought, even in many years, I'd be touched by that. And I'm going to give Bridget a sweet 5.
There we go. Did the question get 5 points? All right. Well, let's get this final properly underway. Yes, here we go. And this is the perfect task to whet the appetite. Hello, Judy.
What is that damn smell?
What do you think it is?
I don't know. It smells like potato.
Oh.
Oh, it just comes off. Identify the liquids.
Most accurately identified liquids wins.
You have 10 minutes.
Your time starts now. This is foul.
Oh, shut up, man. There's some in there. Oh, that is grotesque.
Am I supposed to be tasting stuff?
All the instructions are on the items.
OK.
Liquid identification is a... I would say it's a forte of mine. It's just the main liquids, though.
What are the 5 main liquids?
The brandy, the water and the milk. They're the only 3 I'm familiar with.
Ardal's right, of course. There are only 3 liquids, the brandy, the water and the milk. So it shouldn't be hard to track them down. Let's crack on.
OK, well, let's crack on with Chris and Bridget.
You may only spray the perfume on your wrist.
Pickled onion. That's the water from a jar of pickled onions.
Well, that's... it might be vinegar.
You may only spray the sponge, but then I can do what I want with the sponge.
What do you want to do with the sponge?
Sniff it, lick it, tell it I love it.
I think it's like lemon squash or something.
Mm-hmm. It's like a strawberry, rosy, pink lemonade kind of thing.
You may only squeeze the pipette into your mouth.
Water. Is it beef stock?
like watery soy sauce.
OK, pop it there, then.
OK.
You may only push the valve with the chopstick. That's ridiculous. And it's warm! It's warm! Why is it warm? Oh, crikey!
Old tea, I think.
Still got 4 minutes.
That's tea. Ah.
You can do whatever you want with the balloon. It just smells like a balloon.
That looks absolutely revolting. Oh, it's got bits in it!
Oh, there it is.
What the hell is that?
What are them bits? What's happening?
What is that?
It smells like a yeasty thing. But why is it that texture?
Is balloon juice a thing?
Bugger.
Well, I've written balloon juice.
Is balloon juice a thing? Is going in the Taskmaster book of quotes. Congratulations. Right. And I really loved it's warm. Why is it warm? just start telling me what they did successfully.
They both got tea, of course they did. Vinegar, Chris, he actually located it to a jar of pickled onions, which is very impressive. He also got stock. He said it was beef stock, it was vegetable stock.
That's fair.
I think we have to acknowledge the word stock.
So I think Bridget got two, Chris got three.
Right, we're stopping again, right now. Watch, now! Hello, and welcome back to our Series 13 final!
Yes, nearly there, and then it's the wrap party afterwards, isn't it? I've heard there's a wrap party, but I still haven't had my invite to the wrap party. Before the break, everyone was trying to identify the liquids we'd prepared for them. Now, here's how Sophie, Ardal and Judi got on.
Ah! Oh! Tastes like chicken soup.
That is stock of some sort. I would say it's a beef stock.
The more accurate, the better.
Right, a Charolais cow. Beef stock from a Charolais cow. Fruit juice. Could be passion fruit.
That smells like lychee fizzy drink.
It's like, lychee juice.
It smells like, onion vinegar.
I don't want to spray this on my wrist. Vinegar.
Oh.
It smells like a packet of salt and vinegar crisp.
That is liquidised crisps.
What flavour?
It's prawn cocktail.
But liquidised?
Yeah. Oh.
Tea.
Tea?
Yeah.
That's 6.5 pounds. I believe in you.
I'm going to leave it to us.
You can do whatever you want with the balloon.
Smells like vomit. Oh, don't be crazy. That is rank.
Mushroom, it's mushroom soup.
That is mushroom soup. You may only push the valve with the chopstick. Okay, I should have done that one before the mushroom soup.
What the?
Sophie, that's just the lid of the valve. You can take it off.
Thank you, telling me.
That is a very strong tea.
Right.
That's two.
OK. So, it's really just the pipette.
It's slightly fizzy. It tastes like ass. Is it Dr. Pepper?
Do we leave it at that?
I think so. Yeah, I mean, I'm covered in it.
Oh, sorry.
So sweet watching you trying to get the lid off a bicycle valve with some chopsticks. It's like you're playing a whole different game of Taskmaster.
I spent like about 5 minutes doing that.
Yeah, you did. But you did well. Got lychee, got tea, got mushroom soup, got onion vinegar.
Well, you helped her. You gave her an extra clue that you didn't give any of us.
Mm. You told her.
He told you that you could use your hand to open the lid on the valve thing of the tyre. She would still be there with those chopsticks trying to get that off if it wasn't for his intercession.
I'm going to figure it out eventually.
I've got to be honest, Ardal, since you've come out here in that red leather jacket, you've developed a real attitude. And you were reckless with the balloon pop. You were more reckless than I thought, especially as you thought it was vomit.
Really and truly, it could have been classed as vomit, because once it burst, it started to mix with all the other stuff. And that's really what vomit is.
That's what vomit is. I didn't realise that your nose was such a powerful weapon in your ass. Lychee, straight.
Yeah.
Genuinely impressive. So a very cautious woman who was only choosing to use one sense did pretty well.
Yes.
By stark contrast, Ardal just seemed hungry.
He got the tea, he got stock, he got mushroom soup. So three for Ardal. Okay. Judi got lychee, vinegar, tea. So that's another 3 points.
Lovely.
Sophie got the most. She got four. Ardal, Judi and Chris all got three. Bridget, two. So it's three to Bridget, four to Ardal, four to Judi, four to Chris and five to Sophie.
Easy. I would like a nice early scoreboard, please, Alex.
OK, well, we're all hoping Judi will win an episode finally, but she's currently in last place with 6 points and Sophie's in the lead with 9 points.
Give me another one.
Of course. Well, here they come. Three wheels, two horns, a bell and a vast quantity of ducks.
Where's Alex? Alex always helps. Alex!
Arrows.
Ducks. I can never have enough ducks.
I feel like ducks are my natural enemy. Sometimes people mispronounce my name as Sophie Ducker, and I hate it.
Get the most ducks in Alex's basket.
You may only hold one duck at a time.
If Alex rings his backwards bell, you must walk backwards until he honks his forwards horn.
Alex will pedal as fast as he can unless you say one of the magic words.
If you say a magic word, Alex will rest for 10 seconds. Oh.
All the magic words are single-use magic words.
Alex will cycle around the circuit for 10 minutes.
Your time starts when Alex honks his horn.
You can only hold one at a time. No, surely not.
Good. Can I ask you before we watch this, did you regret this task?
Yes.
Once you had to cycle lots? I've been told that you were in a great deal of pain.
Yes.
And I'm very much looking forward to it.
Right.
Who are we going to see first?
It's Ardal and Chris up first. That's right, the basic boys ride again.
Backwards bell, forwards horn. Magic words. Just random magic words. Oh, my God.
Ah, Alex, come back.
Here I come.
I don't know a magic word. I don't know what they are.
No.
Shazam. Abracadabra. Monkey!
Abracadabra? No, it's not one of the magic words?
No.
Fiddlesticks?
No.
Flash?
Where are these magic words?
Shoes?
No.
Quack.
Closer.
Annoying? Oh!
That was nice.
Duck.
Nearly.
Duggy. Duckling.
No.
Goose. Head boy.
Head boy.
Architecture.
I absolutely hate you.
Oh, God. Still looking for the magic word?
Yeah.
Okay.
This is absolutely horrible.
Yeah. 10 seconds.
You're a psychopath. You're a psychopath.
Still really disappointed about not getting the magic words. You're
still looking for the magic word?
Yeah.
Okay.
A fairly impressive start, I would say. Which magic words were identified? Ardal incorrectly shouted architect.
Well, he shouted 45 things.
Have you got a list?
Of course I've got a list. He started well with Shazam, Abracadabra and Monkey.
That's really big magic words.
Yeah. Very quickly with things like blazers, trouble, shoes, sausages. So he didn't get any of the magic words, but he
well,
said...
I was very close.
You were very close, yeah. You were. I mean, I wanted you to get one so I could have a rest, but you didn't get any.
But Chris did.
Chris got annoying and ducky. All right, well, I'm not going to tell you any numbers yet, Greg.
All right, then.
We've seen them beetle about after me, but now it's Sophie and me and Bridget and a trike and some ducks.
Oh, he's honked his horn at night. I want it a trike. That can't be right, can it? I should probably be doing it in a different way, I think.
Ah, now we... hello. You all right? Ah! Quite a lot of ducks left over there.
Oh, is ducky a magic word? How long do you have to stay there for?
7 more seconds. I'm sure you're making the most of it.
Is there anything I can use to keep them... Oh, can I take it off?
I've got to go now. Sophie?
Yeah?
I don't want to run you over. I have to follow those arrows.
OK.
You have to walk backwards now.
Yeah, but I'm here doing this. I'm busy.
Yeah. Oh. It's frustrating because the arrows are pointing at each other now. Something like this.
You're doing really well.
Thank you. Frustrating. Thanks, Bridget.
Bye bye. Thank you so much.
No, thank you.
You're right, that's harsh. You didn't have to make yourself do that.
I do everything for him.
It's probably a sad indictment on my life that I found I do everything for him genuinely touching. There were some genius moves going on there. I thought the reversing of the arrows so that this fool had spin before you was delightful. And Bridget, the ripping off of the basket.
I didn't know it would come off.
I almost stood up and cheered. Because I knew this toss pot had to carry on cycling while you stack the...
My grandmother used to call me a toss pot, genuinely.
Oh. Yeah.
And then I thought about what that might mean.
I think it's just toss odds and sods in.
Oh, OK, I was thinking too much about it. Right.
Right, let's leave things there a moment and have a rest. you. Welcome back. And listen up. The competition will soon be over, but I refuse to let things continue until I've seen Judy Love try to fill a basket on a trike with ducks.
You're in luck, Greg, but I do first want to remind you that they can only hold one duck at a time. Here we go. It's Judy Love.
Hello, Judy.
Can you stop, please?
Not unless you say a magic word.
Thank you. Oh!
Hello, Judy.
Hello.
Oh.
Are you all right, haven't you?
Yeah, I'm all right. I'd like to say... Judy. The chain's come off. Broken the bike. I need to mend the bike.
What's happened, Alex? Let me have a look.
No, I want you to have a look. You broke it.
But the time's going.
I know. Here we go. All right.
OK, come back round, Alex. I don't like running. Alex, you all Hold on a minute, Alex.
Judy.
Come on, quickly, we've got 35 seconds. Alex, get down.
Oh. Well, thank you, Judy.
Is the bike all right now?
Yeah, this bit looks fine, and this chain's perfect.
OK.
Thanks, Judy.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye.
Well, it wasn't a huge surprise to me that you physically intimidated him. I felt quite sorry for you.
Thank you. I was quite desperate. I didn't notice you handling more than one duck at a time till afterwards because I was so upset
never,
about
I never had more than one duck at a time. No, what you need to understand, the ducks felt some motherly instincts from me. They wanted to be nursed in these breasts. Supposed to say no to the little ducklings, huh? How am I supposed to do that?
She broke the rules, yeah?
Yes, absolutely.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
La, la, la.
And the bike. She broke the rules and the bike. So, unfortunately, Judy... Judy did get 90 ducks in my basket.
I saved 90 ducks!
They weren't in danger!
They were in...
Plastic, Judy!
Yes, so the numbers were that Bridget got all 148 of the ducks into the basket. Chris actually got more than Sophie, despite Sophie's system, four more. Chris, 65, Sophie, 61, Ardal, 48. So those are sort of the numbers.
Yeah?
Yeah. Although, before you score it, I do have to show you one more video. Remember how well Bridget Christie did? She did also do this.
You can only hold one at a time. No, surely not. You may only hold one duck at a time. You may only hold one duck at a time. One duck at a time. Only hold one duck at a time. That can't be right. One at a time? That can't be right. One in each hand? No, one at a time. Is it really only one at a time? That can't be right.
That can't be right.
No, surely not. Right, I've done one at a time.
One at a time.
Time. Time. Time. One duck.
Oh, there you go.
I'm so sorry.
I don't take any pleasure in that at all.
It's totally fair.
Well, that's no fun. What a heartbreaking end. Let's award the points.
Yes, well, it's Ardal 3 points, Sophie 4 points, but Chris gets the full 5 points.
There it is. Is it time for the final task?
It is, and also it's time for the final team task of the series. So, for the last time, let's see the Fab Five face the music.
Hello, Ardal.
Hi. Oh, thank you.
Hello, Chris.
Hello.
You've started, have you, Bridget?
Sorry, has our time started yet?
Maybe it has.
It maybe has.
OK.
Do you have a hairy chest?
Yeah, well, yes.
I think you look quite dapper.
Yeah? Well, OK. No, so that's now. Yes, I wish it did. Can you open the task, please?
Record the best multi-track song about your team.
Oh, God damn it.
You must record all six tracks with your voice or body.
And each person must record the same number of tracks.
Most powerful multi-track song wins.
You have 20 minutes.
Worth reading the last line, I think, before...
Do you think? Should we read the last line?
Your time starts now.
Great.
So one thing we could beatbox.
I mean, I could whistle.
Can anyone sing?
No.
Well, I have been told a few times that, you know, my voice.
OK, you're going to sing.
OK.
Track one, beat.
Yeah.
Track two, cymbal.
OK.
Track three, some kind of rattling noise.
Yes, yes.
Track four, vocals.
Vocals,
track
yes.
five, vocals.
OK.
Track six, humming or some shit.
Yes. Yes, I like that one. OK, OK.
That's one song right there.
That'll do, that, we'll do that then.
I mean, obviously, we're hugely inspired by Taskmaster himself, yeah? Yeah? Always yes. keep that in mind, OK?
I do like the sycophantic angle, I really
Yeah, but
do.
We can't make it too unsubtle, you know what I mean?
Right, OK, you got to let them know.
Well, we could say we do it sort of for you.
Do it with you in mind.
With you in mind.
Let's just freestyle. We're like the freestyle house queens.
That's quite good.
House queens.
That's good. House queens.
Something about how unbreakable we are as a team. What's an unbreakable thing? Like what?
Diamond.
Diamond. Yeah. We're actually called the Water Diamonds. So by the Water Diamonds.
The Water Diamonds are a band from Fleetwood.
You're joking.
No. They're already a band.
Yeah.
The Tungsten Diamonds.
Just checking it now.
Why have we wasted at least 5 minutes coming up with a band name when that is literally the least important thing at this whole godforsaken task?
Well, straight away, I think the House Queens seem to be driven by a baseless confidence. They were full of confidence. Bridget went her own way. Sure, whistling like my grandfather. perhaps less confident in the boys. You sort of had the energy of... sort of two low-level bank clerks that are trying to get
down. Yeah, and they've come up with an uplifting anthem to show you their love for you, but not too obviously.
Oh, good. I wouldn't want you to show it too obviously.
Here we go. It's a really old boy band called the Tungsten Diamonds.
Chris. Oh, Chris.
Ardal and Chris.
Chris.
Chris and Ardal.
Chris. Thicker than water. That's what they say. That's what they say. But our team juice is even thicker than blood. Yeah, we care. We really, really care.
In a high-five standoff, we'll take your fucking hand off, score a hat-trick with a yoga ball stag, do banter with know-it-all, cooler than ice sliding down a pole, and if you want an aubergine shifted, give us a call.
You put an aubergine in my mouth.
Chris.
You put an aubergine in my mouth. We care and we want to please Mr. T. We love you, Mr. T. Everything we do it with you in mind, Mr. T. You inspire me. And Chris. You put an aubergine in my mouth. Chris. I love you, Chris.
I literally don't know what's going on. I don't know what I've just heard.
Annoyingly, the couple of tasks that I rapped about haven't been shown in the series, so that's including the aubergine one, yes. So that's just gobbledygook.
Well, that's good to know, because I literally thought you'd gone mad.
I don't
don't know what he's talking about, this aubergine toast. The women didn't have to do an aubergine toast.
Didn't do an aubergine toast.
I think he's making that up.
Okay.
I put an aubergine in his mouth.
I don't think we'd make you do
yeah.
that.
Yeah.
I can't.
You've got to believe us.
It doesn't sound like this show.
Right. We've just got one itty-bitty part left to go. I'm going to miss these guys. I don't always say that, but that doesn't make it any less scripted. Welcome back, my dear, dear friends. It's the final part of our grand final. Isn't that exciting, Alex?
I'm so sorry, Greg.
It's OK. We all need to unwind sometimes.
Well, I know, but I should have been concentrating.
Hey, I've got you a ticket for the party later.
Thank you so much.
It's all good. Where were we?
Well, the teams are trying to make the most powerful multi-track song. We've seen the boys make beautiful music. Now, finally, here's Bridget, Judi and Sophie's composition.
Welcome to House Queens. Good night, Your Majesties. Come on now, come give me a twirl. We're going to let all our rhymes unfurl to the boys and girls all around the world, cause you gotta listen to the House Queens.
One team, one dream. We all scream for the House Queens. One team, one dream. We all scream for the House Queens. One team, one dream. We all scream for the House Queens. One team, one dream. We all scream for the House Queens.
Taskmaster, things faster. We're gonna cook you some pasta. We're gonna take you into the other room and beat you till you need a plaster. Oh, Greg, what you doing? Why you sitting there on that throne? Cause when the House Queens come into the Taskmaster house, you're gonna be left all alone.
One team, one dream. We all scream for the House Queens. One team, one dream. We all scream for the House Queens.
Enter the House Queens.
Oh my God. I feel foolish for doubting that that whistle would fit in.
Like a glove.
Absolutely slid in. In the song, I appear to be being fed pasta before you beat me and give me a plaster.
Yeah. That's how you show love. With carbs, pasta.
Is there any aubergine in this pasta?
No, but there's rice at home, Chris.
Right.
I never doubted the House Queens.
The House Queens and Bez.
You know...
I've got to defend Bridget, because Bez never whistled on any of those.
She also, she also provided all the percussion, the stomping.
Yeah, the stomping, which was... Yeah.
That was quite hard to do, actually. Yeah,
the damp style, it was unique.
Well, I...
Well, it was more flamboyant than that, Greg. Do you want to see the dancing again?
I would love to see the dancing again.
Oh, don't.
It actually brought me to mind something that happened earlier on in the series. Do you remember a bit when Bridget was walking and it was funny?
I remember several bits when, when I've enjoyed Bridget's walk.
Well, it turns out she dances exactly the same way as she walks.
Singing.
The singing was nice. I mean, they are both cracking tracks. Let me acknowledge that first. I don't think there would be many people who would question the superiority of One Team, One Dream for the House Queens. I'm going to give the girls 5 points each, but I'm going to give the boys a sweet 3 points each.
So three to the boys, five to the girls!
All right, here we go. Please make your way to the stage for the final task of the series!
Hello.
Still really pumped.
Who's going to read out the final task, you silly boy?
I would like Judy Love to read the last one out.
Draw a life-size self-portrait. Your nose must be poking through your nose hole at all times. Most accurate self-portrait wins. You have 200 seconds.
So you're going to be stepping behind your canvases, poking your nose through the triangle, so you won't be able to see what you're doing or what you're doing it with.
Place them behind the canvases.
All right, there you go. We do need noses protruding at all times, Greg. 200 seconds. Good luck. And they're off, Greg. Oh, yes. I mean, I've got an instant favourite, Greg.
Features. Features. Accuracy.
There are some good ones.
There are some good ones. Remember the features that you have.
And remember the features that all humans have.
All human beings have.
I would say, unless you have a rectangular head, worth doing an outline.
Think about the things you need to be able to see and hear.
OK, you have just 5 seconds left.
If you look like a giant frog, that's great.
OK, please, stop drawing. So at this point, I'll ask you to step back on your circles. Please don't look at your canvases. Greg, you're going to judge, but first of all, I'm going to ask Ardal to step forward. Is it like looking in the mirror, Ardal?
Similar, yeah.
Just lovely.
Bridget, would you like to step forward and have a look at your picture? It's not bad.
It isn't bad. I think I'd get a better idea if Bridget was dancing.
It's pretty good. All right, Chris, would you like to step forward and have a look at yours?
It's not bad at all.
It's better than I draw when I'm looking at the canvas.
Are you ready to see yourself, Judy?
Yes.
It's absolutely incredible, isn't it?
Look at the eyes and the eyelashes and look at the eyeshadow.
If only you could have remembered the eyes themselves.
One left to see. Sophie, do you want to step forward and have a look at yours?
I've got ears, I've got the hair.
Got the floating eye.
The flowers. No, these are the two eyes.
Yeah, I know that. It's just one of them isn't on your fucking head.
Greg, you could have judged these.
Do you want me to go from the top?
Let's go from the bottom.
Why are you looking at Ardal? If the eyes weren't directly on top of the head and you got any features right, I wouldn't be giving you 1 point. Judy, yours is quite rubbish. 2 points. I like Sophie's because I think it captures something of the woman. But I don't like it as much as the other two.
OK, so 3 points to Sophie Duker?
No, I'm going to give 4 points to Sophie Duker and I'm going to give 5 points to the other two because I think they really do capture each other. But there's something of the energy of that that I like.
There we go. So Bridget and Chris get the 5 points.
Please come down and we'll see how that's affected the final scores. Come, my friend. Oh, yeah. What a competition.
Yes, so you gave out the scores, Greg.
Yes.
And Judy, as we know, has not won an episode.
And you're building up to say that she's...
Well, last again, yes. So Judy... at one end of the leaderboard, it's Judy with 13. At the other, 22 points go to Sophie Duker.
Sophie Duker wins the episode. You're the conflicted winner of other people's precious heirlooms. Please go and collect your thing. Join us for the presentation of our hallowed trophy. In just a few moments, a life will change forever. So here we go. The suspense is immeasurable. Please, little Alex Hoon. What are the final scores?
Well, in fifth place, but I do need to make it clear, she is the highest scoring loser we've ever had. with 142 points. It's Judi Love! On 153 points and wearing a wonderful leather jacket, it's Ardal O'Hanlon! In third place with 157 points, it's the wonderful Bridget Christie! And then they've been trading places throughout the series, but with 170 points in second place, we have Chris Ramsey.
Wow.
He was right up there throughout, and just 3 points behind this series winner, who had 173 points.
Our brand new Taskmaster champion is Sophie Juker! Please, thank you. We'll see you next time.